Hey YouTube, welcome back to my channel. This is Canadian Retro. I've got a video response here to a series of questions that Retro Pro Frank nominated me for, whatever you call it, tagged me in to answer. So it's a pretty long list here. It's called the half and half challenge. It basically means a half are video game related and half are personal. So I'll get into this. Hopefully you'll get to learn a little bit more about me or my video game things. A lot of this stuff I think might be doubles. I do a lot of these videos, people tag me quite frequently. So some of this might be a little bit of double up from, you know, game to game kind of thing or whatever you like to call it. But still, you know, as far as the personal stuff, probably haven't shared a whole ton of that. I mean, other than video game related stuff on this channel, so maybe you'll learn something. Okay, so the first question here is, what is a game that you were skeptical of that ended up being fantastic? And for me, I have a hard time answering this question just because I've never really gone and bothered to play a game that I thought was awful because I would think that it was awful, so why would I play it? I've never really looked at those kind of things. Like, as far as like checking out games, I've always checked out things that I thought I'd be interested in. So there's been a few games I'd say that were disappointing. I was expecting a little bit more out of them. But when it comes to the other way around, I've really never encountered that kind of scenario. So I don't really have an answer for this question, so I'm just gonna move on. If you could have an item from any video game, what would it be? And I'm not gonna really narrow it down to one item just because all of these items are very similar and they're all in the same game, and that is the helmets that you get in Kid Chameleon. Just because in that game, you get all those different kind of helmets, gives you a whole bunch of different kinds of varying abilities, from like ninja abilities. You can be like an axe wielder, you can turn yourself into like a little mini tank. There's a whole bunch of different kind of really cool power-ups that you get from the helmets in that game, so it'd be really wicked to be able to, you know, on the fly kind of switch from different power to different power. So I think it's a little bit cheating that I get to choose all those helmets, but they're all in one video game and I couldn't really narrow it down to just one, so there you go right there. The next question here is, the third question rather, is what is the best video game related gift you've ever received from a friend? And you know, I don't really want to anger anybody here, but as far as, you know, YouTubers and all kind of stuff that have sent me numerous gifts over the course of these years that I've been making content, there's probably one gift here that really stands out for me and really has like a lot of special place in my heart kind of thing. And I'm not gonna pull it down because it's sort of on the shelf there, but I will show you a picture of it. And that's the NES action set that my wife gave me. Not that she gave it to me, but she had it in her basement for a very long time. And I had the system, it was just the box and everything, but I was able to complete it. And it's one of the best things I think I have in my collection. And it's in such immaculate shape that it's just such an amazing gift. And I received that from her, she said I could have it. So that was something that I've really appreciated. And that also came along with a whole bunch of different boxes for games that I had the games for, so I was able to complete those. That was really wicked. What is a game, the next question rather, is what is a game that you really enjoyed but no one else seems to know about? And I've already talked about this many times on my channel because it's always like one of those kind of questions, like underrated, underappreciated, those kind of things. And those are pretty much in all these tags kind of videos, so this is going to be no big surprise to anybody who's watched my channel before. But the game is called Deception 3, and it's on PlayStation 1. Go check it out. It's the one where you set up like traps and all that stuff. I'm not going to go into grand detail on this just because you've heard it from me before. If you haven't heard from me before, go check it out. It's called Deception 3, Dark Delusion. Really, really, really good game on the PS1, and I still play it today. And you know, sometimes those PS1 games, some of them are a little rough to go back to with like the different kind of controls in it. It's pretty beautiful. It still stands up, still looks great, even if you're playing on a PS3. So I'd go check it out. The last one here is, what's a game that you think deserves a sequel or a modern remake? And I already mentioned it in this video, and that is Kid Chameleon on the Sega Genesis. Obviously needs a remake in the modern day with all the interchanging abilities, the vast different kinds of levels, the amazing music and sound effects in it, just something of like a rebuild of it. I think it should still be like a 2D kind of thing, but you know, that sort of had a little bit of a resurgence, I think, in the current day kind of situation where you know, things like Shovel Knight, or there's a variety of different games out there that are like this sort of 2D kind of idea, sort of getting like a major hype back sort of thing. It really needs an HD remake, but you know, in that classic kind of style, and I think Kid Chameleon would definitely be it. It was sort of Sega's attempt at like mascot-y kind of things, and it really didn't go anywhere from there. As far as I know, I don't think there's a Kid Chameleon 2. If there is, let me know, but as far as the sequel or modern remake, that game definitely needs one because it is tons of fun. Moving on, we'll get into the personal questions now. First one here is, who is your favorite musician or band? And this is a very difficult question to ask because it really would depend on so many variety of different factors, but I'm just going to throw a couple of them out there. As far as like one of my favorite bands of all time, I'd have to say it's Ween. I don't know if you've ever heard of Ween before. A little bit obscure, I think, not necessarily totally mainstream, although they've had a few hits here and there. But their music is just so diverse and like very playful and just all over the place, kind of different styles. So I really appreciate their work for that. And if you haven't checked out any of Ween's stuff, go check it out. I'm sure you can figure out there's like tons of videos and stuff like that on YouTube. A really good like 90s kind of band, and I think they're back together again. They're playing actually a show very close to me in Toronto coming up here, but I don't want to give any of the details of that away because I really want to get tickets for myself for it. So what's next here is the second question is, what is something you really liked as a kid but don't care for now? There's a couple of different things I think I would put on this list. And one of those things would be just in general, and don't get me wrong, I like sweets, but for some reason, when I'm out at dinner and things like that, I really don't enjoy having dessert, like cake, these kinds of things. Not really my thing. I will scarf it down. It's not that I hate it. It's just as a kid, you know, I really love that sugary kind of stuff. Now I'm more all about like the actual meal itself, whereas maybe as a kid, I was sort of like, I want to eat this so I can have dessert. It's kind of the other way around now. So, you know, that's sort of one of those things, is dessert would be the thing that I really liked as a kid, but I'm not as interested in now. I don't really don't care for it, I wouldn't say, but just not as interested. Number three is, what is something dumb you did as a teenager? And this is something that pretty much like encompassed part of my grade 9 year, probably the first part of it. In grade 9, actually since the end of grade 7, when I was a kid, I had a job working as a dishwasher in a kitchen, and probably around grade 9, I think I started doing preparatory work a little bit, so I was making some decent money, especially, you know, living at home and not having like a lot of expenses, and just back in the day, your dollar could carry a little bit further. So I usually had like quite a bit of cash on me, like not walking around throwing cash around or anything like that. I was pretty reasonable with my money when I was a kid, but you know, when I was at school or whatever, people would often ask me for, you know, like 10 bucks, 5 bucks here or whatever. And honestly, to me, it wasn't that big of a deal to hand it out, but I was finding that people weren't really reciprocating it back. And I really learned a valuable lesson from that. I wasn't really thinking it at the time, obviously. When you think about it, you know, just doing like handouts like that, probably not really the best idea. I wasn't really trying to use it to manipulate people or to get them to do what I wanted or anything like that. I was just trying to be generous, and I thought my generosity would be reciprocated, and in that case, that never really did happen. So I really learned a valuable lesson. It's something that as a teenager, I probably should have known better. So that's something, you know, I'd have to fess up to there. I don't really like to mention it, but that's something that I did. It didn't go on for very long because I learned very quickly who you could trust and who you couldn't. And I guess that was one way to do it. So if it's a valuable lesson that, you know, I had to spend a little bit of money on, then I ended up doing that. So it was definitely well worth it in the long run. Number four is, what did you want to be when you grew up? And the funny thing is, I never really had that sort of thought, I don't think. I can't think back to anything I particularly wanted to be. I mean, you know, every like Halloween or something like that, you wanted to be something different or whatever, but I never really went through a long thought process about what I wanted to be when I grew up kind of idea. So I don't really have an answer for this question. You know, as a kid, what did I want to be? I don't know. I really didn't know. It took me a while to figure out what I wanted to be. And if that's the case that you're in, don't panic. You'll end up doing something worthwhile. It's just sometimes that's the way that it goes. Sometimes people sort of get into a habit, I think, of what do you want to be and what path are you going to take and all this kind of stuff. And for me, that decision came a lot later on. And I think for other people, there's a lot of pressure to figure that out when they're a kid. I never really had that kind of pressure or felt that kind of pressure, so it never really occurred to me. Number five is, if you could go back and do one thing differently, what would it be? And this is a really simple thing, because I often think about this, but I never do anything about it. And what it is I would love to have learned some sort of musical instrument, particularly probably the guitar, just because my father knew how to play guitar, and I really enjoyed that. I mean, I can remember, like, oftentimes sitting around listening to my father play guitar, and I never could quite figure out why I never got around to playing guitar. I know that the school that I went to, in elementary school, didn't really have, like, a music program that was very virile, or whatever you'd like to call it. I was basically like recorder and ukulele, and that was about it. Not really a whole lot going on there. There was no music specialists there. It was just teachers that were teaching there had to teach music, kind of idea, very small school. So I always felt that I was sort of musically like inept as far as playing a musical instrument, because I knew that people in the high school, not the high school, but the school that was like near our school, they had like a full like band kind of thing. So I always thought I was a little bit behind, and it never really encouraged me to do that. And obviously that's just like horrible thinking. You know, that's a kid's way of thinking. Obviously, you could probably do that at any point if you really wanted to pick it up and go figure it out. But I never really got around to doing that, and I really put that back on to, you know, just like your thought process as a kid. You're like, oh, these people are so far ahead, I'll never catch up, blah, 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 blah. And you never like end up doing it. And if there's any advice that I can give you from something like that, is absolutely just go for it. It doesn't matter like what your skill set or level or whatever you like to call it, or how you feel about that particular scenario. If you want to do it, go ahead and do it. Don't let anything stop you. I think my sort of like younger mind stopped me from doing that, and it's something that I sort of you know, regret over the years. And obviously I could probably go and try to learn some now, but at this point I just sort of have developed like other interests and things like that. But it's something that I've always been interested in, just haven't really never got around to doing anything. So that's something I definitely would do differently. But other than that, I'd like to thank Retro Pro Frank for tagging me in this. Some interesting questions, I think, in here, that's for sure. Some of these things, obviously, I've answered before in other videos, but some interesting stuff came up, so I thought it was pretty cool. So the last thing I need to do here is to tag a couple of people to do this challenge as well, just to keep the challenge going kind of thing. And I'm going to tag, and I'm gonna cheat a little bit here, because I'm gonna tag two people in one, and that's the Q Dogs. They need to go and make a response to this. I'm gonna put the questions and all that down below in the description box, so that you guys can see all the different questions here, because I had to write this all down. There's so many different questions, and I'm sure you'll have to do the same. But absolutely, go check out their channel. Like always, I'll put a link to their channel down below as well. And that's everything I got for you guys this time around. Thanks again for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. Go check out Retro Pro Frank's channel. That's really wicked as well. Lots of cool, really arcade kind of stuff there. He builds his own like MAME cabinets and whatnot. Step by step, shows you all the steps that he goes through. Really cool stuff right there. And that's everything. So I will see you all later.